everyone, Shaky Tam here and welcome to another taste test. Today I'm going to be looking at what's in this box of stuff that Louise has generously sent me from the UK. So let's get started. Oh, I've got lots of postcards, which is really beautiful. This is from sunny Colville. Oh, wow. Okay, so it's Louise's hometown. How lovely. I've noticed Louise actually wrote something here, which I find strange. Hey, up me duck. What's that mean? She's also included a local paper. Interesting looking people there in Colville, haven't you? I shouldn't say that, you might be related to them. They might be your best friend. Oh goodness, I'm realising what I'm holding up here. She's given me this little booklet too of the Colville Trail. It's got the history and stuff. So when I actually finally get to visit there one day, hopefully, fingers crossed, no, I'll say, hey Louise, I'm in town, give me a tour. Oh, I love these. Sorry, sometimes I get weird. And I get emotional and I want to cry. Oh, there's another one. Sorry, mate. Oh, there's another Smurf in here. Oh, wow. Does he do something? I feel like he does. Oh, no, he doesn't. I don't know what I was expecting him to do, but he has a filthy great big hole in the back of his head. Here's a little quick sneak peek. So let's get started on a UK taste test. First up, I've got these, and this looks really pretty. I love the box that this comes in, and it's won some sort of grand award, so this has got to be good, hasn't it? How beautiful is this box, this packaging? And this is from Cookie Man. Oh, no, Cookie Moon. The Curious Adventures of Monty Bojangles. Who's he? Am I supposed to know who he is? I don't know him. Oh wow, I even love the inside of the box. You may notice your heart quicken, your breathing becomes short and feathered. What's going on here? Your eyes widen and twinkle. A naughty smile. What? A naughty smile plays across your lips. Fret not, I won't. This is all perfectly normal. Something oh so good is coming. Comes in this packet inside here. What's in there? It's quite big. Seriously. Oh, whoa, whoa. Is it supposed to look like this? Looks a little bit like a doorstop. Oh. Oh. It's chocolate. Whoa. Oh, I like it though. Look at the mess I made. I saw that Cookie Moon and I was expecting a cookie in here, but it's more like a chocolate that has bits of cookie in it. It's really rich, chocolatey, truffle flavoured, and it's actually yum yum. It's rich, you can make yourself sick on it, but I like it. Next up, I've got this little squash Milky Bar thing, and I think it used to be a chicken. We do have Milky Bar here. I've never actually seen these little things though. They're very cute. Obviously, Louise has sent me these for Easter, and Easter's come and gone. And this is a time in the year where I go, what happened and why am I not more organized? Let's have a look at this, because it actually is really cute. He is very melted and squashed. That's what happens when you come to Australia. I mean, not like in the plane or I don't know, some of you might get melted and squashed in the plane. He looks like he's had a haunting of a lifetime, doesn't he? I love Milky Bar. It's a sweet white chocolate and this is really tasty. This is Walker's Crisp and this is Max Strong. It's perfect with beer. I don't have a beer. It's jalapeno and cheese flavour. It looks like these ones are on fire. Will they be hot? Let's find out. They look really good. They're crinkle cut chips. I was not expecting them to be that hot. They really pack a punch and they're really cheesy, which I love. I love the flavour in them. Lots of flavour. Super, super hot, but yum. There's another packet of chips. Sorry, that was a bit weird. They're a West Country Cheddar and Red Onion Chutney Crisps. They look very upmarket. There they are. They're nice and crispy. They do taste like they're kettle cooked, tastes like they've been made by hand. There's a cheddar flavour in there, which is quite mild, and then it sort of tastes a little bit jammy. I don't think it was a good idea to follow these ones with this one. It kind of dull down the flavor a little bit and they don't taste that cheesy to me. And I think it's because these were super, super flavorsome. But they are still quite nice. These ones are pleasant. You'd have these with a beer. I don't drink beer, by the way. Next up, I've got these Fruitella gummies. And I love the packaging, really nice and bright. 30% less sugar, more fruit juice. Fantastic how they put juice in there. Look at these. They're lovely little gummy candies. They're very pretty. Ooh, and they're really, really fruity smelling. Oh wow, lots of different flavors here. Hello. Look at how beautiful these are. So you've got a pear, a little lemon. Oh, look, it's a raspberry with a face, an orange, and a strawberry. Let's try this pear one. Mmm, oh, those are nice. They're quite soft and nice to eat. I swallowed that one whole. Let's try the raspberry one. Mmm, yum. Just gonna try this lemon one. Love them. These are really cute and really yummy and they've got heaps of flavor in them. They taste really fruity, yum. Next up, happy Easter everyone. I know Easter's over. These ones are mini eggs nest cakes. I have never seen these before. We don't have them. They're a Cadbury product, but then of course in the UK, you get some things and then we don't get them and then vice versa. That's how we can all be jealous of each other and say, well, why do you get those and we don't? I don't know these answers. This has four individual cakes inside. This is what they look like. They're actually really cute. How pretty is this? And it's got a little tiny mini egg on the top there. They're really chocolatey. Wow. It's predominantly chocolate cake in the middle there, and then it's also got a little bit of cream there, like sweet mock cream stuff. Then it's coated with chocolate on the outside, and then it's got chocolate sprinkles as well. And then you've got the Cadbury egg on the top with a candy coat. They're really good. Why don't we get these? Why? Next up, I've got this Walker's Lovely Licorice Toffee. I'm probably gonna love this. I can't get it out. It's very hard to get out of the plastic. Is that normal? Okay, I need scissors. Oh, wow. How do you eat this without drooling all over yourself? Hope it's easy to bite into. Oh, it's not. Oh, yeah. Oh, that is yummy. Mmm. It's a really sweet licorice chew toffee thing. They're not the most delicate little thing to eat in the world, are they? If you're trying to impress that special someone in your life, I probably wouldn't grab this and start hoeing into it. Then you'll start drooling black down your face. Just some people might like that, I don't know. That is so delicious. I love this one. I'm a big licorice lover, so this one, love it. Thank you so much, Louise and Sophie. I really do appreciate you getting me all these amazing items and yum. These are really good. And if everyone in the comments below could thank Louise and Sophie for sending me all of these things, because without them, this taste test would not be possible. Please remember to give this video the thumbs up, share, and subscribe for more. I'll see you next time. Have a great week. Bye.